Welcome to the news. 欢迎来到今天的新闻联播，我是峰峰。11月26号上午，世界首例免疫艾滋病的基因编辑婴儿在中国诞生的消息引起冉冉大波。这是什么冉啊？Gene editing on human embryos. Is it a good thing or not? 我们来谈一下。不久以前，有一些科学家发明了一个叫 CRISPR-Cas9， 就是可以编辑一个人的基因。好处在 you can get rid of diseases in humans, which is good, right? No more cancer, no more 艾滋病。No more Parkinson's disease 等等。之前还没有一个人在一个婴儿的 embryo 上做了一个基因的编辑，但是26号上午，一个姓贺的在油管上传了一个视频。
Two beautiful little Chinese girl named Lulu and Lala. When Lulu and Lala was just a single cell, this surgery removed the doorway through which HIV entered to infect people.A few days later, before returning Lulu and Lala to Greece warm, we checked how the gene surgery went by whole genome sequencing. The result indicated that the surgery worked safely as intended.
虽然这个科技已经存在已经有大概10年，但是其他的国家，包括中国所有国家都反对在一个人的 embryo 上使用。到现在我们不会完全了解这个对一个 embryo 的发展，或者他们长大以后会有什么样的反应，太危险了。 No one knows what will happen to an edited genome baby when they grow old, when they have other children. What is going to happen? Their genes have been edited. SoWhat effects will it have on their future generations and on themselves when they get older? Will they be more easy to get cancer? Will they be prone to other diseases? The thing is, we don't know. There's no way of knowing. So a lot of people are angry about what Mr. 姓贺的人做了。他们很生气，为什么呢？因为他就自己主动打开了这个很危险的箱子。大家都知道这个技术的存在，但是没有人去做了，因为是违法的，因为我们不知道后果是什么。但这个姓贺的就直接做了。有个评论说得好，在技术上没有任何突破，被突破的只有科研人员的底线。There's technically no breakthrough, only the bottom line broken. So I guess that's the problem. Is this a moral, 一个道德的问题，或者一个技术的问题，或者是什么问题呢？ So the real issue comes up with, it worked, what does that mean? If it didn't work, if a problem happens, what does that mean? So if there's a problem with the genome edited baby, that baby is so screwed.So screwed, and that baby all its life is going to have blood taking out of it just to see if there's a problem. It's not going to be a happy baby. It might not get AIDS, but it's going to be tested on for its whole life. So the other question is like, why did he do it to these babies? Was he paid? Like, is this a money thing? Like, why didn't you do it on your own kids if you're so desperate to do it? Why do you have to get a stranger's baby? Like, oh, we don't want our baby to get AIDS. I'll help you. I'll break all the laws in...science, yeah? Now give me $10,000,000吧。虽然我只是一个普通的主持人峰峰，所以我没有自己的意见，但是我觉得这样做不太好。但有好有坏。The good thing is, at least someone's done it. Like, everyone was waiting, like, should we do it? Should we not do it? And he's done it, and everyone's like, okay, he's done it, let's see what happens. But I think the bad bit outweighs the good bit by quite a lot. The bad bit, apart from what if the baby has problems and then is like,suffers its whole life. Well, good job, scientist man, good job. Number two, if it works very well, what's stopping other people from doing it? Because you don't just have to edit the immunization against AIDS. You can edit anything. You can make your child smarter. You can give it blonde hair and blue eyes if you wanted to. I know one guy that wanted to do that, and it didn't turn out very well, did it? No. So what if you can get your kid to have massive IQ and be really handsome?Who wouldn't do that? Like, genuinely, who wouldn't do that? Of course, if everyone else is doing it, and your kid's an ugly, stupid kid, you're gonna want it to be a smart, handsome kid. And if that means paying some money and getting the DNA edited when it's a child, everyone will do it. And that sets a very, very dangerous precedent. So I don't know if you've ever seen the movie Gattaca, Basically, they edit the genes of the baby before it's born so they know how smart it's going to be. And then every other baby who's not smart gets discriminated against and basically works shit jobs, whereas the smart edited gene baby gets all the good jobs. The non-gene edited kids don't find girlfriends, they can't get a good job, they're poor, and they just die off. So is this a good thing? Having gene edited babies, everyone's just going to be super smart, and if you don't get fixed,You won't be smart. Now guess what? All the rich people are going to have smart babies and all the poor people are going to have stupid babies. There's going to be a lot of discrimination. All right, I may be thinking a little bit too far ahead now. 我只是放放一个主持人 But that's the direction that this experiment takes us in. And even though in the video he's like, I don't agree with it. It's not about agreeing or disagreeing with it. It's about having the ability to do it. Like,When has disagreeing and agreeing ever stopped people before? No, they'll just do it. Who cares? If you can get a super intelligent baby, people are going to pay for it, right? So f**k this guy. 我只是一个普通的主持人峰峰 But f**k this 姓贺的 F**k you man, don't do that shit. Don't do that shit. 我大概说的我想说的事情我不是我没有意见我只是说说我只是一个普通的主持人但是如果有人有其他的想法你可以在下面评论或者在我的其他的平台评论好了今天的视频就拍到这儿了就想说这么多关于这个事情我是峰峰你们最喜欢的主持人下次再见拜拜